right, now back to this. I love this idea. I love decorating the Christmas tree around the holidays. Yes. But this tree in particular is really something that's special just for the kids.
It's for the kids. And my son JJ, who is 13 months, he is into everything. And so putting up a Christmas tree, it's always safety first. You can see, they got a lot of energy
in our house. Look at how animated both those boys
are. Yeah, really. And JJ, my baby, is so... He's so curious, and he's grabbing everything and climbing everything.
It can be dangerous.
So it can be dangerous. So we're very, we have the gate around the tree, but he loves the tree. So I really wanted to create something for him specifically. And, it kind of gives him something to play with and to do all season long.
It's super cute. Exactly. Because you can take it into, you could take the ornaments off and use it for something else. Even a tent.
Yes.
So a tent, put a little hole in it. So what materials do we need to get started?
So this is actually very simple. It looks very impressive, but all you really need is upholstery foam. That's the base of it. And I have a cone pattern that I'm going to talk about as well. Some felt. And I'll use some scissors and some spray adhesive. And that's kind of the base. Yeah, the basis of this. And it's Fabri-Tac.
All right. Well, you got started earlier.
I did get started earlier. So I'll show you how I made this. So this is just a cone pattern that I got online and blew up. So really, you can just go online and do that. And what I'm doing is I'm actually tracing it onto the upholstery foam, and I'm using a paint pen. You could use a Sharpie or something like that as well. And I'm cutting it with an electric knife just to make my life a little bit easier, but you could really use a pair of scissors when you're doing this.
Okay.
Now I'm placing it onto a very large sheet of felt. And what I'm doing basically, because I got, too much felt, so I'm really just cutting it down so it's easier to work with. So I took some just chalk and kind of cut around it.
All right.
And I'm using my fabric scissors just to cut around the shape. And so, after that, I take more chalk and do more of an accurate shape of the cone, the pattern of the cone.
And you're going to use that felt anyway to make
the ornament. Exactly, exactly. So I use some tape to put it down, and what I'm doing there, you want to make sure it's really on there, really tight and smooth. And then I use my spray adhesive just to spray it on there and kind of let it get tacky as I'm spraying the upholstery foam as well. And what I do is the both sticky sides to each other.
Okay.
So you just use your hands to kind of push it down. And the one side of the cone shape, one of the sharper sides, not the rounded side, I leave an extra 2 inches. The other one, the other areas of the cone shape, I leave about an inch, depending on how thick your upholstery foam is. And that is where we are now.
Right.
And so what you do is, to create the cone shape, you first bring the ends together, which is what I have up here. And I put just a safety pin on the top because it kind of helped to bring everything together. Because it's going to want to go back to being flat.
Of course, yes.
And so really, to bring everything together, it takes a little finagling to kind of bring everything together. But really, because I have those extra 2 inches of fabric, you can see as I bring it down here, this extra 2 inches of fabric
really
is going to cross over,
to fold over,
and that is what makes it flat.
So that's important.
Exactly. Here, Deb.
Let's start this way. Otherwise, you're going to see the
foam. And I'll show you a little bit, because I actually found, just by kind of working with this a little bit, I used some tape and some safety pins just to kind of have it down.
And then you went back and glued?
And I went in and glued, but it helps to have a Debbie around, because Debbie can kind of hold it like that.
And so two sets of hands is good.
And you can take your Fabri-Tac and kind of go in through here and then readjust your tape, readjust your safety pins, and things like that. So we can, and what you do is you actually end up looking like this. So see how it's nice and flush to the top of the cone over here.
And then you have a nice finished.
Exactly. So it does take a little bit of time because the Fabri-Tac needs to dry.
All right.
So you kind of have to do some
pins. Hold it and go.
And that's it. Yeah, we can set this
section by section.
Exactly.
So then after we have our tree done, which is super adorable.
Yes, we can set this aside. So
the only thing left to do is decorate. So how do we decorate?
So here, all you do, Deb, is you actually just, I have my pieces of felt here, and it's just felt. Felt sticks to felt.
Which is so
fun. I mean, it's just, it's overly exciting and oddly satisfying, to quote Orly. So what you do is you do this with you could do chalk or a Sharpie, create your image. I used cookie cutters because that's what I have around, but you can use any stencil. You can cut pictures out online and do things around them. But after you have it cut out, that.
And which is, again, so much fun for the kids.
It's so much fun. And they can put them wherever. Yeah.
Look at that.
And
it's just so easy. And you can move the things here.
Yes.
Look, I'm going to move this. I'm going to go right there. Watch me do that. There.
And so that way you don't have to worry about putting Velcro in certain places and everything just kind of sticks.
And then we make the topper for the tree.
We make the topper with just another cone. And all I did was, this is felt, and I just twist like that. I secure it with, you can either use Fabri-Tac or you could use a hot glue gun.
Oh,
and my little star.
Wait a minute, but wouldn't it just stick?
It could.
Look, you don't even need it. Oh, well, you do. Just for safety. There you go. And where would you put this in the house, Maria?
Okay, so this could really go anywhere because it's super soft. If, you know, my son JJ is playing with it and falls onto it, it's just like a pillow.
Right, exactly.
But like any other toy, I will say you want adult supervision because just for safety purposes. But other than that, it's really fun and easy and squishy for them to play with.
It is super cute. Maria, I love that. Thank you so much for this idea. What a great idea for everyone out there with little ones.